some things I can't get used to. No matter how I try, it's like the more you give, the more I want.
Valentine's Day is coming up. It's tomorrow, I believe. And is that a big day for you?
Yes and no. Like, I've never really put much emphasis on it. Like, I've been single during Valentine's Day. I've been in a relationship. Either way, I'm fine with it.
But
Jeremy's looking mighty fine.
Jeremy
like
looks
it.
Good.
Yeah.
Yeah. But if you had some, what would an ideal Valentine's Day date be? It's a lot of pressure to do something really. If you had someone, I don't know if you do or not, but if you had someone in your life to spend Valentine's Day with, not that guy. Don't look at him. He's that's our underwear model. That's Jeremy.
Super
the stereotypical. You want roses and chocolates
all day long,
and like a big stuffed teddy bear that someone's selling
massive
on the side
bear.
Of the
like
road.
I want the biggest bear, and I want like 1,000 roses. I mean, if we're gonna do it, we might as well do it full out.
Yeah, that's what you want.
Ah, God, I really don't know. The truth is, I don't know. I think something simple, sweet, meaningful is great. And, you know, I love flowers, so flowers are nice. Chocolates, who doesn't like chocolates?
Oh, so that's very stereotypical. You want, like, but I'm just wondering, do you keep in touch with that cast at all?
Yeah, we all keep in touch.
Yeah? Who, anybody more than the others? Okay, it's good to know. Like I said, I don't know if there's anyone in your life or not, so I'm not going to push on that. Let's just change the subject entirely. So, you were on that show, that 70s show. Oh, remember that? That's Ashton Kutcher. That's, is that Ashton Kutcher?
I don't know.
Yeah.
I've worked with him.
Yeah, so,
yeah.
How is he doing, I wonder?
You know, it's been... Give or take a couple minutes.
Oh. Couple minutes? So we're good. You keep it good.
Yeah.
Have you talked to him at all? Just recently. I don't know how. When's the last time you talked to him? I don't know. I'm just asking. Curious. It's an entertainment. It's a showbiz question. Is it
all
just
right.
The thought of him? Are you very emotional?
You are in such trouble.
So I'm not. I'm just asking a question.
Totally.
I'm an interviewer.
Totally.
So do you watch the show? If it comes on, if you're switching?
Yeah.
Now when what's happening?
My eyes tear up when I get nervous.
Oh. Yeah, forever. All right, we have to take a break. And do you need to call anyone, or? All right, we'll take a break. We'll be back. We'll talk about the movie. Channels?
No.
No?
No. That, honest truth, no. No, who wants to see themselves going through puberty? I don't. Right? Like,
no.
That's no fun. Why do we live that?
No.
Well, and it's on film for everybody
forever.
Else to see.
Can I help you?
Hey, sorry to bother you. I've been hiking all day, and I saw you had a hose out here, and I was wondering if I could fill up my water bottle.
I have a hose?
Yeah, bottom of the stairs.
Go for me.
Should I...
I'm sorry, what?
Should I wipe my feet? I don't want to track beach sand into your... house sand?
Oh, no. I have filtered water in the kitchen.
Oh, I kind of had my heart set on dirty hose water, but if you insist.
That's not sand. That's the remains of the guy who used to live here.
No, maybe I'll just use the hose outside.
No, it's not like that. He gets spilled all the time. At this point, he's mostly lint. I'm Walden.
Your desk is backwards.
Excuse me?
Well, you have this beautiful view of the ocean, and yet your desk is facing the wall with a picture of the ocean on it.
Yeah.
Vivian.
That's a beautiful name.
Thank you. My parents got it from that 70s show. What was it called? Maud.
Ah.
Yeah.
Actually, it's the Atlantic. It's an inside joke. for myself. I mean, you can wait it out here if you want. We got dinner together. I'll order delivery.
Really? Wow. Yeah. That'd be great.
Great.
Okay. Thank you. You know what? I better fill up and get going.
But it's like really starting to come down up there.
It's just a little water. I'm not gonna melt. It's not like I'm the Wicked Witch of the West.
So what's your deal, Walden? Good-looking guy, rich, Malibu beach house. I bet you only date hot actresses.
God, no. I'd never date an actress. They're all crazy. I know, but I have to say, I am a sucker for anything having to do with Brangelina or Kimye.
Yeah, I have no idea what that means. I thought we were eating Kimye. I'm sure they're not all crazy.
Trust me, they are.
I don't get this whole fascination with celebrities anyway. I mean, who cares who's dating whom or who's engaged to who or who has a sex tape that no one will ever, ever see? And once, I was an assistant manager at a hot dog on a stick in Pittsburgh.
I love hot dogs. I've never even thought about doing stuff like that. I mean, although I did once sit in the splash section at SeaWorld without a poncho. Have you been hiding under a rock for the last 3 years?
No, but I have climbed a few. I was a Sherpa in Nepal. Yeah. And I drove cattle in Argentina. And I used to give safari tours in Africa.
I took my underwear off in the car.
Hey, listen, we need to talk. I mean, nothing happened physically. It's just, I can't stop thinking about her, and it's made me question everything, including my sanity.
Are you saying that you want to be with this girl now? Awfully serious for someone who just got hit in the face with a thong.
Here's the thing. While you were gone, I met someone.
What? Wow.
Listen, I'm sorry. I never meant to hurt you.
I don't feel the same.
Hi.
Remember how you asked me if I was gonna be okay? I don't think I am.
Is it because I just kicked you in the balls?
Is that?
I'll be fine. I mean, this is what I do.
Okay.
Walden?
Yeah.
Are you gonna be okay?
I do think I'm gonna be okay.
You had known Ashton Kutcher for a long time.
Yeah.
And then now you were having children with him. When did it move from the friend zone to the end zone?
The truth is, we both did a movie. I did a movie called Friends with Benefits, and he did a movie called No Strings Attached.
Yes.
And if we would have just paid attention to how those movies turned out, we would know that we can't go into a relationship this way.
Yeah.
And yet we did exactly as both those movies.
But when does it change from, like, look, there's that guy, and then suddenly you're like, oh, hang on.
I know, right?
Was it like a haircut or something?
Kind of. So I... It's so weird. I still get so nervous talking about it.
Don't be nervous. It's a safe place.
Yeah. Foretold. Like, we literally shook hands. We're like, we're gonna have fun because we're both single and young. 3 months later, we're living together. 6 months later, we're like married and have a kid. Like, literally, we clearly didn't watch the end of either one of our movies. Like, yeah, like, it's on all levels.
Mm.
Then we went our separate ways, and in our 20s, always kept in touch on, you know, AOL iChat.
Oh, yeah.
So we would always be like, hey, how's it going? How's life? Like, always just, you know, but we both had independent relationships, went all, like, had a whole separate life. I never thought this. Okay, so I was a kid when I started 70s Show, and everybody was much older. Like, Ashton did my chemistry homework for me. Like, he was so not the guy that I was like, oh, you're so hot. Like, I was just like,
it would have been inappropriate.
It just wasn't even, it was totes
inappropriate.
Like, oh my God, I haven't seen you in so long. And I was like, yeah, okay. And then he was like, why don't you come over to my house for a housewarming party?
Oh, yeah. Someone's about to get punked, yeah.
Kind of, yes. I ran into him at an award show, and at first I was like, wow, that guy's really tall. Like, that's what I thought. And then he turned around and I went, and then that moment that you hear or see in movies where like your heart skips a beat,
yeah.
And it happened with Ashton, and I was like, stop it. Like, I was like, no. And that didn't happen.
Yeah.
Who was the friend?
Oddly enough, that friend ended up dating somebody that my husband went on a date with later. Like, it's all meant to be. And very, no, it's all good. It's all good. So before the punking happened.
Yeah.
I found out later in life that my husband was trying to set me up on a blind date with one of his best friends that night.
Oh, so he was like,
come over, and he had like a friend that he wanted to set me up with.
You were here, you surprised your lovely wife, and little did we know that she was pregnant when she was sitting here on that show.
Yeah, she was preggo.
Yep.
But then I was afraid I was gonna come out here and spill the beans because I have a tendency to do that, and so it got disconcerting.
Yeah, no, I did not know, and now he's in the world. His name is Dimitri.
Yeah.
That's a great name.
Thanks.
She
was at that mark, you know, where, right before you can tell people.
Uh-huh.
And so it was, but like you got, she's like, she was worried that people might know, and I was like, nobody's gonna know. But then you said something, and then she thought that you knew, but you didn't know.
I didn't know.
So we're on our way to the date night. And Mila turns to me, she goes, so I think Donald Trump's going to become the president, and I think our baby's name is Dimitri. And I was like, Donald Trump's not going to win. And then I forgot about the name thing.
Yeah.
So that's it.
And then Trump became president.
Everything Mila said is right. But she's my wife, so that's just what it is.
Yeah.
Everything she says is right.
Always right.
So I was like, it's not real. And we ended up not talking about it. And then 2 weeks later, I got home from work, and for some reason, the name just stuck in my head. And I was like, I think Dimitri is the name of the baby. And she was like, I know, right? And I was like, yeah, that's it.
Congratulations, you got an award already for in Iowa for character.
Yeah.
Yeah. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Great. Did you get it yet?
Yeah, no. Like, nominated for awards and things like this, I sort of, like, shirk away from it, because it seems like being a person of good character is just something that you should just do, like, not that you should get an award for. But then I was like, I had to give a speech, and I was like, what am I going to talk? Like, I don't, like... And then I got pulled over by a state trooper when I was high on mushrooms. I'm like, I don't know if I'm... like, am I the character guy here, right? Like, I don't know if that's... I got arrested in Iowa. It was like going back to my home state. I got arrested for like a third-degree burglary. It was like a felony offense, and I got a deferred judgment on it when I was in high school.
Lifestyle.
Do you want to have more children?
Yeah, absolutely.
You do.
Yeah.
Do you want to have more children?
No.
Oh, that's right. You said you just want to have my child.
Man on man is all I can handle. I feel like I'd be too scattered. I'm already very scattered, so I can't.
So is this what this turned into? I mean, yes, you know, I'm...
You're trying.
Yes. Yeah. Not like that, but yes.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
It just seems like... you brought it up.
No,
Are you trying?
Am I having sex? Ellen.
Yeah, are you having sex? That's my question. I want to know how often you're having sex. That was my fault. I think you did.
Why is this? I'm always blushing on your show. Go on, say something. Distract Ellen.
Say something.
How's the sex?
How old? That's a good
question. You brought it up.
That's a great question. He does.
So
he seems like he'd be attentive.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
I imagine it's good.
Yeah,
it's
great.
Yeah.
I feel like he'd be a generous
one. Oh, my God.
Yeah. And it's sweet.
Oh, my God.
God. Look at that.
That's
the first time I've seen that photo.
I don't know where that came from.
What is happening?
All right, we have a little surprise. So you're both married to, and your husbands know each other too, because Dax was on Punk'd, right?
Yes.
When Ashton was doing Punk'd.
Yeah.
So they're both handsome, and they're
and
both wonderful, tall, handsome.
True. Yeah.
We're supposed to be watching those kids right now, but we're not.
No. We're wishing you a happy Mother's Day and letting someone else worry about it.
Guys, watch that.
Happy Mother's Day!
Happy Mother's Day! We put babies in you.
Yeah!
And then they came out.
You gave them to us, and we thank you.
And now they're in the world.
And also, thanks for being good earners, too.
Yeah.
We'd play a really, really fun game, and it's called Never Have I Ever. Take one, pass it down, and I'm gonna.
Oh, we have never.
Never have we ever.
Oh, we.
All right.
So, life, you have to.
Oh, I guess I'm. Never have we ever hooked up on set.
What?
Yeah.
Sorry, was that? Now, was
never have we ever hooked up on set.
Oh,
yeah. Never have
Sorry,
we
guys.
Ever.
Sorry, guys. This Hollywood lifestyle is not as exciting as it's advertised. Yeah.
Never have we ever used each other's toothbrushes without telling them.
Oh.
Who cares?
Oh, that's
yeah, I mean, we don't even.
I don't know. Never have we ever fallen asleep making love. No.
She. Well, no, that's
like one
I was gonna say she has started asleep. And then woke up.
All right, so I'm going to ask you a question, and you have to be honest. Never have we ever been to a nude beach. Never. All right, good
shame.
Don't do that.
No!
That's not nice. That's not.
Why,
I don't know that we have separate toothbrushes.
Yeah.
We travel with one.
Yeah. Everyone knows our story because I told it here, but when I was pregnant. But when did you groom him?
Oh, I didn't groom him. He groomed me when I was pregnant, right before I went to the hospital.
Oh, okay. Well, we groomed each other, so I guess we're the better couple. Anyway.
Well.
Or maybe.
Never have we ever waxed each other's body parts.
Waxed?
Well, can we be loose on that term, guys? We're the judges. We're the judges.
Like shaved? Groomed? Are you trying to shave?
How about groomed each other?
All right, we can say that.
Oh, yeah.
Never have we ever thrown something out of our spouses that we hated without telling them.
Thrown out?
Thrown
yeah.
out or
thrown
given away?
Out.
Does given away count?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, you have? But
I did the thing.
Oh.
Something we got you?
No.
What did y'all give away?
Honest to God, every time she goes out of town for more than 48 hours, I get rid of about 20 things. But luckily, her memory is so terrible, she has no idea.
Yeah, he
Turn
has.
Turn that down. Yeah.
Wait, you threw something of hers out?
I gave it away.
What was yeah. it?
I gave it away.
It was a gift that he didn't realize that I actually liked.
She didn't like it. It kind of got a poo-poo. It was like, man, put it in the drawer. And then,
because like her mother, she collects all kinds of things. I think she's planning on opening up an antique shop in her retirement or something, but, you know, there'll be time
Everything
for that.
Everything has a use.
Yeah.
Never have we ever been in handcuffs.
Never have we
Oh, you have because you're just talking about the movie now.
No.
Well, she says no, and you say
He's talking about another partner, Ellen.
All right, never have we ever given each other massages.
No.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. Who doesn't like massages?
No. I'm talking about the police and stuff. Is that not what that means? That was a sexual thing. Normally, all I think is sexual stuff, but this time I went legal.
Maybe it's you.